imagine what happened. Now you heard the video, you heard the footage with the him and the Meek. Now we also know that T is allegedly also a power bottom, and he's a much older man, and they say he's very enthusiastic.
Jaguar Wright has returned to the limelight, and this time she is making news for her accusations concerning her hidden cooperation with federal investigators. In a recent live broadcast, just minutes after Diddy's arrest was announced, Jaguar released bombshell after bombshell, alleging she had been an FBI informant for years. This revelation has left fans and followers stunned and curious about the truth behind her bold claims. Jaguar's current charges go well beyond her previous criticisms of the music business. She claims to have had a significant role in exposing Diddy's alleged wrongdoings. According to her, everything she has published on social media is just the tip of the iceberg. In her live video, she alluded to a wealth of data she had accumulated over the years, revealing a web of corruption and exploitation, including Diddy and his inner circle. One especially worrisome component of her accusations concerns her personal interactions with Diddy, whom she characterizes as a key role in freak-off parties. Jaguar said that these parties were riddled with depravity, and she did not hesitate to level surprising claims against Diddy himself, implying that he had a more active role in the misbehavior than previously believed. She implied that he was not only a participant but also an organizer of these occasions, enlisting other persons to partake in very improper and criminal acts. But Jaguar did not stop there. She also said that Diddy's kids, Justin and Christian, were also participating in these horrible incidents. According to her, they have been embroiled in crimes as heinous as those she blames on their father. She stated that the culture of exploitation and wrongdoing goes deep inside Diddy's family, implying a disturbing heritage that may extend beyond just one person. Jaguar followed up her assertions with what she called receipts, which served as proof for her charges. While the details of this proof are unknown, the fact that she has paperwork may add weight to her claims. In the realm of celebrity gossip and surprising disclosures, the concept of compelling evidence has the ability to significantly influence public opinion if proven. As her stream progressed, Jaguar portrayed a gloomy image of the music business, emphasizing the risks lying beneath the beautiful surface. She highlighted that her reason for coming out stems from a desire for justice and responsibility, not just for herself but also for the numerous other victims caught in the crossfire of Diddy's and his colleagues' acts. She was frustrated by the lack of attention these concerns have gotten, especially from those who have benefited from the business. This shocking discovery has caused a heated debate online, with both fans and detractors weighing in on the ramifications of Jaguar's assertions. Many are skeptical, doubting her motives and the accuracy of her information. Others, however, are rising in her support, calling for a more thorough inquiry into the claims she has made. Following Diddy's arrest and these stunning accusations, the narrative around him and his reputation seem to be rapidly changing. Jaguar Wright has established herself as a whistleblower, a role that many may find surprising but ultimately vital in a world where responsibility is frequently elusive. Whether or not her charges are true, one thing is certain: Jaguar Wright is not going quietly, and her voice can be heard across the music business, challenging the established system and demanding that dark realities be revealed. As additional details emerge as the tale progresses, it becomes evident that this is just the start of a much broader saga. The mechanics of celebrity culture, power, and responsibility are all being scrutinized, and the consequences of Jaguar's discoveries might extend well beyond the people directly implicated. The consequences of her charges might spark a much-needed reckoning throughout the business, changing the landscape forever.
The only thing that's going to make any of this hoopla worth it is if he does a perp walk, if he gets put into a car, if he is treated like the criminal that he is on camera.
Diddy is definitely the focus of attention right now, but not for the reasons he would choose. After a succession of disturbing claims and many lawsuits alleging sexual assault, he was ultimately detained by federal authorities. The announcement has sent shockwaves across social media, with individuals trying to absorb the specifics of the high-profile case. During a recent search on his residence, investigators allegedly confiscated over 1,000 bottles of baby oil and lubricants, raising concerns about the nature of the activities going on behind closed doors. The charges against Diddy are both alarming and complicated. According to several sources, he is accused of coercing women into having sexual relations with male prostitutes, only to leave them so fatigued that they needed IV infusions for hydration afterwards. This unsettling information implies a predatory pattern of conduct in which the woman's well-being was used as a tool for his personal enjoyment. It is said that he recorded these meetings and used them as leverage over his victims to keep power and quiet. As if this wasn't surprising enough, the indictment claims Diddy brought in a slew of sex workers to attend freak-off parties. These meetings apparently included many of his friends and acquaintances, and the festivities lasted several hours. The enormity of these incidents provides a bleak image of a lifestyle entrenched in exploitation and abuse, raising major concerns about the culture of celebrity power and its potential for damage. Jaguar Wright. A musician and activist who has been outspoken about the darker aspects of the music business, has long spoken out against Diddy. Since 2019, she has claimed that Diddy was participating in these illegal operations, only to face widespread criticism for her assertions. Critics labeled her as jealous or unstable, and even questioned her mental health. Her life was allegedly endangered, and she experienced legal issues, including a contentious arrest related to an outstanding warrant for a U-Haul vehicle that she had failed to return. Many onlookers highlighted the obviously excessive reaction, seeing it as a clear warning from influential business players to silence her. Despite the pressure and intimidation, Jaguar refused to give up. She has continued to speak her truth, bringing to light concerns that many people would rather ignore. Her tenacity has earned her a devoted following, who appreciate her bravery in the face of hardship. As the Diddy case progresses, her earlier warnings are being reviewed with renewed seriousness and importance. The contrast between Diddy's rise to prominence and these charges raises larger questions about responsibility in the entertainment business. For years, prominent figures have been sheltered from scrutiny, often dodging prosecution while their victims suffer in silence. Jaguar's unwavering search for the truth has sparked a conversation about the treatment of women, especially in areas controlled by strong men. As additional information regarding Diddy's alleged conduct becomes available, people are reviewing Jaguar's accusations and asking why they were first ignored. The narrative is changing. What was formerly deemed a conspiracy or hyperbole is now accepted seriously. The fallout from Diddy's alleged actions is far-reaching, impacting not just the individuals directly engaged but also casting a lengthy shadow over the music business as a whole. The topic is not confined to Diddy and Jaguar. It has spurred a broader discussion about structural faults in the entertainment industry. How many others have suffered similar circumstances but were quiet or ignored? The bravery shown by people like Jaguar is critical in the battle against such injustices. As the lawsuit progresses and the public gets more aware of the problematic dynamics at play, it is unclear how this will affect Diddy's legacy and the future of those who have dared to speak out against him. One thing is certain: Jaguar Wright's voice has emerged as a strong force for change, challenging not just the established quo, but also inspiring others to share their own experiences. The developing story is a striking reminder of the intricacies of celebrity power and the critical need for responsibility.
Every time I've been arrested for something that I didn't do, and yet nobody said, but did he get arrested finally and get the book ready to be thrown at his very, very, very dancing feet? Y'all watch me get arrested there just for bringing Gene Deal to Dallas.
If anything, the roadblocks they placed at her made her even more determined to tell the truth, because she's back at it following Diddy's arrest, and she's got much more to say only minutes after Diddy's arrest was made public. Jaguar hopped on an emergency live broadcast with Real Life Productions and dropped significant beans about the intel that she's received, collecting on Diddy over the years and how she's been in contact with Cassie and the feds. She started off her live stream by demanding that the feds humiliate the life out of Diddy by taking him on a parody walk on the streets of New York. For those of you who don't know, a parlor walk is an outdated American tradition where a suspect who's been arrested is taken around the city in handcuffs right after arrest out in public, usually from the police station to the vehicle. The defendant is generally handcuffed or physically detained and is occasionally clothed in prison guards. This is commonly done in New York City, according to Jaguar. Diddy needs this type of treatment so that photographs of him in his handcuffs and jail outfit are published all over the press, sending dread to his partners.
I want the twisty ties. I want him on the ground. I want people putting his head into the car. I want that. That's what they did to the kids.
Yeah, there's never been an image of Diddy in handcuffs.
No, we need that. We need that. I need that perp walk. So as I keep reaching out to victims, I can let them know It's safe to come outside. I want my perp walk. That's all I want. The only thing that's going to make any of this hoopla worth it is if he does a perp walk, if he gets put into a car, if he is treated like the criminal that he is on camera. See, they got all of these images leading up to the secret arrest of him having a good time and doing all of that. But when is he going to start having a bad time? I want his passport surrendered. And I want a perp walk. I want to see him look as humiliated as he should look after what he put those boys through.
Jaguar Wright didn't hold back during her latest chats, revisiting the notorious audio recording that emerged a few months ago, documenting a horrifying moment at one of Diddy's purported freak-off parties. The tape shows Diddy forcefully interacting with Meek Mill, whose agonizing cries raise fundamental issues about power relations and consent in these scenarios. Jaguar alluded to this footage as proof of Diddy's poisonous atmosphere, emphasizing the horrific nature of what happened. Jaguar's discoveries did not end there. She also made charges against Bishop, a well-known industry figure, claiming that he was a power bottom at these gatherings. According to her accusations, Bishop has reportedly been exposed to Diddy's advances for years, compounding the storyline around the conduct at these gatherings. Jaguar's statements depict a problematic and predatory society in which boundaries are breached and consent is often ignored. These charges have serious consequences. They not only challenge Diddy's behaviors, but also highlight the involvement of others in the business who may have turned a blind eye to such behavior. By revealing these interactions, Jaguar hopes to illuminate the darker side of celebrity culture, where power and privilege can lead to widespread exploitation. The effect of these allegations has resonated throughout social media and the entertainment business, raising debates about responsibility and how people are treated in the industry. Jaguar's determination to speak out, despite the personal dangers she has taken, serves as a rallying call for others who have been hushed for far too long. Her statements force others to face painful facts about the individuals they like and the structures that keep them safe. As other people join the discourse, it becomes evident that Jaguar Wright's discoveries are part of a bigger movement demanding justice and transparency in an industry long plagued by abuses of power. The stunning nature of these charges continues to unravel, as does the potential for significant change in how such practices are regarded and dealt with.
Imagine what happened. Now you heard the video, you heard the footage with the him and the Meek. Now, we also know that is allegedly also a power bottom. And he's a much older man. And they say he's very enthusiastic in his endeavors. What happens when he pops something loose? You know what I'm saying? Why would a bishop have a ghost account?
Account immediately, in case you forgot. Meek was revealed as Diddy's boy toy a few months ago by one of Diddy's ex-bodyguards shared a horrible recording of a time when he caught Diddy violating the heck out of Meek's hole. Now I'm about to play the audio for you, but let me tell you, it's probably going to leave you extremely horrified and bewildered. The allegations got even worse when a video of Meek in the pool with his lightly curved, as if he was trying to ease some pain down there went viral. In the video, Diddy can be heard calling him daddy and applauding him for putting in that work after a freak-off session with him. Man, you doing it, man, you deserve it. Daddy, you putting in that work, proud of you. I love you. Yeah, as if this wasn't troubling enough, the ex-bodyguard who recorded the audio later made a video explaining how he managed to get the audio, and the story behind it was just as disturbing as the audio.
Like, all the champagne was spiked. Everybody was passed the fuck out. I don't drink, so I was playing that shit off like I don't fucking drink. I smoke, nigga. Like, I smoke and I had my own, but like, everybody was passed out. Yo, Diddy had that man in the room. Look, yes, I put my ear to the fucking door and I brought the phone because Diddy started going in overdrive. I ain't know what the fuck was going on, but I just heard balls slapping against ass cheeks. I heard struggling to take Diddy. I heard being like, yeah, daddy, like when he started all that daddy this and daddy that, and then I heard some hollering and struggling, like, yeah, I kept the phone there and I recorded all this because I was like,
everybody kind of knew back in the day that Meek Mills and Puff was a little too friendly. Anytime two rappers or two people in the industry come dressed up alike on more than one occasion,
Now, when it comes to the rumors about him allegedly being Diddy's power bottom and taking that BBC like a champ that have been going around for a while now. A lot of people accused him of this because of his strong affiliations with Diddy and how he always made it a point to attend every single one of Diddy's parties. In fact, back in 2021, they announced thanks to everyone that had Everyone I In It was rumored that was bringing his sermon to Diddy's Revolt TV during the live Diddy was talking about how helped him come out of a bad spot and how he's forever thankful for his support. I mean, even before 3 years ago, I was going through a bad phase of my life, you know, I just lost everything, you know, a female friend. To mother, my children died, my closest friend Andre Harrell passed, and a lot of things that just really took my head and my soul, simply I was in a dark place. I started like watching you and listening to you, it gave me hope and provided me strength. Not only that, but you stepped up to defend Diddy at the time of Kim Porter's death when everyone was accusing Diddy of having a hand in it. And then there's this viral video of Diddy pulling up to Sunday service where the both of them were spotted standing together while Diddy was seemingly doing the Illuminati sign. They kept looking at each other awkwardly before Diddy laid his head down. Even now, heading back to Jaguar, she was not done with Diddy just yet. She also went in on his kids, Justin and Christian, for L Lightly, and essaying a lady by the name of Love Jones.
Storm Monroe was live today with a young woman I think y'all need to reach out to. She's a subscriber, but she's also a content creator here on YouTube. She has over 50,000 subscribers. Her name is Love Jones. Today, Love Jones sat with Storm Monroe, and she talked about being with the Combs brothers last summer in a Sprinter, and she don't remember where they took her.
Okay.
The boys.
Right.
And apparently, and King, right. And she said it was more than DeLeon. Her body tingled all over, and she's...
Lawsuit Christian Combs groped Omar's legs, breast, behind, and her C. The lawsuit also details audio recordings in which it states Omari can be heard declining alcohol, saying she had to leave, and telling Christian Combs to stop touching her with what sounds like kissing noises in the background. He was erected, and he grabbed her arms and was trying to force her to perform oral surgery on him. Apparently, this happened the same night that music producer Lil Rod, who also filed the essay fact Lil Rod attached several incriminating photos of everyone who was at that freak-off party, and it included none other than Diddy's son Justin's child. This entire case had everyone on the edge of their seats, and it's safe to say Diddy's trial is going to be one for the history books. As usual, people had their own thoughts about this, like this person who said Jag is the female version of Kat. I never once doubted what she said. That lady has so much info that it's mind-blowing. For 5 years, her facts have correlated with times and dates. This sister has survived the industry and chose to protect her talent, but now I want to know your thoughts. What do you think about Jaguar Wright coming out with all this information about Diddy, and do you really believe she was working with the feds and Cassie this whole time? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below, and don't forget to click here to watch this other very messy video.